Hi, I'm Sophia Kalbag, Managing Director at Nilsinside. And this illustrates a Carnot heat engine consisting of a grey cylinder, which is a closed system containing an ideal gas as a working volume. The cylinder has perfectly insulated walls and a perfectly conducting base, an ideal and theoretical situation. Its moving boundary on top is a perfectly insulated and frictionless piston. The red body is the source maintained at a fixed high temperature. The source has infinite thermal capacity, so any amount of heat can be taken out without changing the temperature of the source. The blue body is an infinite sink at a lower temperature. Any amount of heat can be added to it without changing its temperature. In between the source and the sink is a perfectly non-conducting area, nil, which thermally insulates the working volume inside the cylinder from its surroundings. The working volume in the cylinder absorbs heat from the source and rejects heat into the sink. The pressure volume changes moves the perfectly insulated frictionless piston. To get a continuous supply of work, the working volume is taken through a series of operations called the Carnot cycle. On the other hand, you need to add work to move the cylinder back and forth in the cycle to the source position, the nil position, the sink, the nil position again, and back over to the source to complete a Carnot cycle. Let's heighten our perspective and introduce what I call the Carnot revolution. The Carnot revolution is a practical implementation of the Carnot cycle that consumes less energy than the old forth and back thing. What could be better than moving a cylinder in a circle? The heat flow to and from the cylinder is restricted by the area of the perfectly conducting base. Better than inventing a cylinder with a perfectly conducting base and perfectly insulated walls, and to avoid friction, is moving just the gas. Simply. So now we introduce the rotating shutter. The shutter opening contains the gas of the working volume, and it exposes the working volume directly to the source surface, the nil surface, the sink surface, and the nil surface again, and back to the source again to complete a Carnot cycle. Next step is not so easy to see, but we just skipped the restricted area. We have expanded the cylinder to include the source, the sink, the shutter, and the nils inside the same volume, and connected an external moving boundary. In this new expanded closed system, the working volume is always in direct contact with the surface of the source, the sink, and the insulation, nil, in between the source and the sink, always. Now, we may use all possible area available within our closed system to transport heat directly to and from our working volume. And the perfectly insulating walls is the surface area of the insulation, the nils inside. The shutter itself is never in contact with any surface. There is always a very thin layer of gas between the freely moving shutter and the surface, acting as an insulating lubricant. This thin layer contains only a very small fraction of the working volume. Most of the gas is, though, in the opening of the rotating shutter. Now we see three separate closed systems, each with its own working volume. You might connect each of these to their own double-acting pistons rotating the same shaft to deliver an impressive steady torque. So what we now have seen is the unique Carlberg energy converter, with lots of area for the heat transfer to convert heat differences to power in big scale. Rotate the shutter with a controlled spin and it simply transforms a heat difference into pressure pulses with the corresponding desired frequency. A moving boundary in form of a piston is only one of several options. This Carlberg energy converter is a true sustainable solution that you will see not only in cars, trucks and ships, but it will also be used in large power stations down to power or heat generators for example, individual homes. The energy converter may be powered by solar, geothermal and biomass heat, and also from waste heat recovery. It can convert waste heat from, for example, data centers, power stations, industrial processes, etc. In fact, it can convert any industrial or agricultural waste heat into very useful energy. This is innovation, aimed to tackle the energy trilemma.